Hello, my name is Najibah Nasuha binti Mohd Hair. You can call me Jiba. I am a fourth year student of Biodiversity and Conservation. My research project is about the investigation of microalgae diversity of temporary water habitat in a 10-hectare permanent plot in Taman Negara Johor and Rompin in Malaysia. Okay, for the background of study, first, temporary water can be found in most regions of the world. The bodies of water that experience a recurrent dry phase of very long. There are two main types of temporary water. First, natural origin, example, seasonal pond, tidal wetlands and lakes. Second, human origin, example, mining, cattle watering pond, fish pond. Temporary waters are among the components of landscape. The temporary water body allowed their communities to perform important ecological services, well represented by micro and macro forms. It serves as habitat to some rare species of amphibians and provide important feeding area for migratory birds. There are four reasons for studying temporary water. First, contribute to general understanding of life history, population dynamics, and community organization. Second, habitat represent convenient system, which is study of ecological concept and suitable for research. Third, frequently harbor for the vector of disease-causing organism that afflict mankind. Four, contain species important to ecosystem and global biodiversity. There are three classifications of temporary water habitat. First, microhabitat, such as axil of plant leaf, tree hole and footprints. Second, mesohabitat, such as temporary water stream or pond. Third, macrohabitat, such as large old riverbed and lake shore. Problem statement. The study of diversity of microalgae in temporary water habitat. Microalgae have their own importance and roles to other living and non-living organisms. Microalgae is a tiny organism that can be observed under microscope. They have their own roles as component of biodiversity. Clean up pollution, production of oxygen as byproduct of photosynthesis, and production of biomass. Threats for them is human activity, natural disaster or extreme weather event. There are two objectives in this research project. First, to determine the distribution and abundance of microalgae in temporary water habitat of a tropical rainforest. Second, to identify the roles and importance of microalgae in temporary water habitat. Next is my research scope. Sampling location, was located in Sungai Semawa, which some part of this river dries up during dry season and flooded during wet season. Temporary water habitat in the 10 hectare community park is located in Taman Negara Johor in Lorong Bay, Indonesia. Samples, duplicate water sample for microalgae will be collected and preserved in the field. In-situ water quality will be determined, whereas microalgae identification will be done in the laboratory. Data analysis, microalgae abundance, species diversity index, evidence. For methodology, there are study sites in Semawak River in Taman Negara Johor in Lorong Bay, Indonesia. GPS, elevation at 46 meter above sea level. I have 6 stations which have different elevation. Next, field sampling. Sample collection will be collected monthly for 3 months. Collection with abandoned water sampler and filter per sample. 3 water sampler for each station. Include physiochemical parameters such as temperature, pH, DO. Laboratory analysis, there are two. First, sample processing will be done in the lab. The water collection will be transferred to opaque plastic bottle. Second, identification and enumeration, which using a compound microscope, each week after for counting. For data analysis, I use 4 formula: species abundance, Shannon River Diversity Index, Margalef Species Richness, Pilo Species Evidence. The result for this research project is the distribution of microalgae will be determined and new species of microalgae is expected. Classify microalgae into genera, families and classes. Next, create understanding of the importance and roles of microalgae in temporary freshwater habitat such as bioindicator of the river and act as food sources of other aquatic organisms living in the river.